part, and all of this is going to happen in the second return of Yahweh Shai. That reward is going to come. Okay? That's what the scripture says in Zephaniah. It says, "But wait ye upon me, saith the Lord." Okay? Until the day when he arrives, okay, to the grave. That's all that's been commanded of us to do, is to wait upon Yahweh Shai. Okay? It's not much that has been required of us to do. Okay? Hey, Yahweh Shai says, "No man is putting his hand into the plow and looking back as way of the kingdom." Okay, we just gotta see all these things through. That's what we're required of us to do, to hold the scattered into revelation. This is what Yahweh Shai said. Because this is all gonna come to pass. Okay, the destruction and demise of this society is gonna come to pass. Okay, death and destruction has been promised by Yahweh Shai to this world, it will come to pass. And those who are gonna be diligent and hold firm, okay, until the end, the same ones are going to be saved when all hell, okay, break loose. This is our revelation. This is the Messiah speaking right here. Okay, it's a Revelation chapter 2, verse 25. Says, but that which ye have, oh, this Revelation chapter 2, verse 25. Says, but that which ye have already hold fast till I come. Okay, hold it firm till he comes. Because Yahweh Shai is on his way. Okay, our Lord and Savior, okay, he's on his way. We must do what? We must hold firm that which we have. Okay, until he comes, he's on his way. There's no doubt. Matthew 24, the disciples were inquiring, asking at Yahweh Shai's feet, "What shall be the end of the times? What shall be the end of the world?" Okay, he gave them what? Signs of all things to happen before the end of the world actually comes in. And we see all these things happening. Diverse earthquakes. Zimbabwe just hit by a 5.5 magnitude of earthquake yesterday morning. Left, right, and center, these earthquakes have been increasing. Well, this is the sign right here that the Messiah is on his way. But people are still asleep. Okay. They still have the same mentality we read about in 2 Peter, the third chapter. Okay, since the days of our forefathers, things have continued, they have continued as they were. But that's not the case. Things have not continued as they were. Okay, now the wicked has been revealed. And right now it's been consumed by the spirit of Yahweh Shai's mouth. Okay, now we know who the wicked is. He's been revealed. So things have not continued since the days of our forefathers. Okay. If things are continued since the days of our forefathers, guess what? Yahweh Shai wouldn't have not came. Yahweh Shai came on the cross. Okay. We now under grace. Since the days of our forefathers, back then in the days of our forefathers, okay, there was no grace. Okay. The sacrificial laws, they stood. But now all these sacrificial laws have been done away with. Okay, because things have not continued since the days of our forefathers. Things have changed. Okay, the door of repentance is open. Okay, the doors of repentance have been opened right now. Okay, unto those who seek, unto those who believe. Alright, the ones who believe in the only begotten Son of the Most High, Yahweh. Okay, those who are of the 12 tribe descendants. These are the only ones who can believe anyway. These are the same ones who are going to be saved. Okay. Irregardless of whatever you look like, okay, whatever language you speak, wherever you've been scouted, these are the same ones who are going to be saved. Because Yahweh Shai made that sacrifice. He was that ultimate sacrifice. Okay, that sacrificial lamb. Okay, John said, John the Baptist says, "Behold, the Lamb of God, the Lamb of the Most High, Yahweh, which taketh away the sins of the world." Okay, the cosmos. Okay, not the Ocumene. Okay. But the cosmos, okay, the ordinary arrangements of the 12 tribes, these are the ones whose sins have been taken away. Okay. These are the ones that their sins have been taken away. Right? This is Revelation chapter 2, verse 25. But that which you have already hold fast till I come. Okay. Let's get Matthew 24. It's the book of Matthew chapter 24. Mm-hmm. verse 13 says, but he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. Matthew chapter 24 verse 13, but he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. So about what? Endurance. Okay, no man putting his hand into the plow, looking back, is fit for the kingdom of heaven. Okay, that's what the scripture says. Alright? That's what the scripture says. It's all about what? Holding firm that which we have, man. And what we have is the word of Yahweh HaMashiach. That's what we have, okay, on our side. Oh, that's the only thing that we have, okay, with us. It's the word of Yahweh HaMashiach. Because here we have no continuing city, okay. What the hell are we going to take with us? Our works, our faith. Okay, Revelation speaks about that. Okay, it says what? And their works to follow them. Okay, we cannot go, we cannot take anything physically with us. Okay, but only what? Only our works. That's the only thing that we're going to be what? We're going to be translated with. Okay. So Ecclesiastes. It's the book of Ecclesiastes. Chapter 9 verse 10 says, whatsoever thy hand findeth to do with thy might, for there is no work, no device, no law, no, it says, no knowledge, no wisdom in the grave, whither thou goest. Okay, this is the time right now to serve Yahweh HaMashiach with all diligence. Baruch says what? 4 and 28. Let's get that. It's a Baruch. So Proverbs chapter 4 verse 28 says, for as it was your mind to go astray from the Most High, so bring the 10 seeking 10 times more. Okay, we're supposed to be going all the way out for Yahweh HaMashiach. Because we're the ones who actually transgress the laws of Yahweh HaMashiach in the first place. So now being returned, okay, guess what? We didn't return of our own will. Okay. We did not return to Yahweh HaMashiach out of our own will. This is the gift. Okay, this is the gift. We got nothing to be proud of. Okay, let's get out of Lamentation. This is a book of Lamentation. This is Lamentation chapter 5 verse 21 says, turn thou us unto thee, O Lord, and we shall be turned. Renew our days as of old. Okay, what were the days of old? Okay, when we were abiding under the ordinances of Yahweh HaMashiach. But this time around, when we return, it's going to be forever. It's going to be in a very glorious format. Okay, it's not going to be through us the sacrificial laws. Okay, us keep on breaking the laws and making sacrifices and returning unto God. No, it's not going to happen like that. This time around, Hebrews 8 and 8, the promise is the new covenant, which is heading the laws, statutes and commandments of the Bible, being embedded and written within the minds, okay, of the Israelites. That's the new covenant. So we're going to be perfect. We're going to be finally perfect. We're never going to be sinning. Okay. We will never transgress the laws. Hence, there will be no more death. Okay, no more sin. Because sin is a transgression of the law. So how can we possibly be transgressing the laws if we're going to be having these laws within us? It's not going to happen. So death is going to be swallowed up. Finally, it's going to, all these things, all the tears, they're all going to be wiped away from us. Okay. The former things, all things are going to pass away. Everything's going to be refreshed. Okay, we're going to start afresh. Okay, on a clean slate. Okay, let's get out of Hebrews. The book of Hebrews, chapter 8. This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 8. This is what the new covenant is. Okay, the new covenant is not that Gentiles can be saved. The new covenant is the promises that the laws that the Israelites broke in the Old Testament, they're going to be embedded, they're going to be written within them, so they will stop trespassing the laws. That's the new covenant. This is the Hebrews chapter 8, verse 8 says, for finding fault with them, he said, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. It does not mention any other nations. Okay, tell me specifically, the new covenant is only for the nation of Israel and none else. So to hell about your pastor saying these hallowed houses, okay? The new covenant is only for the nation of Israel and none else, which are you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans, the 12 tribes. This is who this new covenant is for. And your descendants will be scattered among all these nations. And the Spirit is bearing witness right now, as we are returning unto the Lord right now. Okay? It says, behold, the day comes, saith the Lord, that will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Not according to the covenant which I made with their fathers in the day that I took them out of the land of Egypt. Okay, because they could not in my covenant as well. Because we kept on transgressing these laws. We never kept these laws 100%. Okay, we tried, but we never kept them 100%. Okay, during the days of Josiah and King David, we nearly kept them nearly perfect. But it was never perfect. But the time is coming right now that's been appointed by the Lord that we're going to keep them 100%. That is going to happen in the kingdom. That's what is promised unto us. That is the new covenant. Okay. Because we are transitioning into the new covenant right now. Okay. And that's going to start off. It's going to start off by who the first fruits, the elect of Yahweh. Okay. Verse 10 says, "For this is the covenant I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their mind and write them in their hearts, and I will be to them a power, and they shall be to me a people, because we once were cast away. Okay, we were once off cast away, but now, okay, we are now returning unto our power, Shemasha. We are no longer being cast away. We are returning unto our power, Yahweh, Shemasha. Okay, we are no longer cast away. Okay, the outcast of Israel have been assembled together. The other sheep that Yahweh spoke of, which is not of this world, which is of this world, which must also be brought in, is happening right now. Okay, we are no longer being cast away by Yahweh Hashem Hashah, okay, as Israelites, okay, only, okay, it says, and they shall not teach every man his neighbor, of which this is happening right now, okay, and who's your neighbor? Your fellow Israelites, this is who your neighbor is, okay. That's what the Lord says, but for ye the foreign houses and hedges and compel them to come in. There will be no longer need, okay, for the servants of the Lord Yahweh Hashem to be out there on the houses and hedges, to be compelling, okay, to be out there on the marketplace. Once Hebrews 8 and 8 comes into fruition, there will be no need for all of them. Okay, let's get out of Matthew. There will be no need for us to be piping at you, okay, because we're going to be in the kingdom right now. Because right now we're blowing the trumpet and we're piping unto you, but you're not listening. But it's fine, okay? It's Matthew. It's Matthew. It's Matthew chapter 11. This is what we're doing right now, okay? If we were already under the new covenant, there would be no need for us to be out there on the streets. But it says that in Hebrews, they shall no longer teach every man his neighbor, saying, know the Lord. Okay, because we see that guys, you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Spanish, Native Americans, which are the Israelites, we see that a lot of chunk of you are lost. You don't know the Lord. What's the name of your power? You don't know his name. Okay, what's the name of the son? You don't know him. If I ask you what the name is, he's gonna tell me his name is God. The name is Jehovah. His name is Yahweh. The name is Yahushua. No, man, you don't know the Lord. That's why the true servants of the Lord, his mouthpiece are out here on the house and hedges. Because you don't know the Lord. You don't know these scriptures. This is Matthew chapter 11. You don't even know what the Lord looks like. what the Messiah looks like, what the Father looks like, what the angels, the hosts of heaven even looks like. Because you don't know the Lord. This is Matthew chapter 11, verse 16. It says, but whereunto shall I liken this generation? It is likened unto the children sitting in the market and calling unto their fellows and saying, we have piped unto you and ye have not danced. We have moaned unto you, but ye have not lamented. Okay, we are piping a song right now, okay? It's a very song that only the 104,000 can learn. This is the song that we're piping right now, okay? This truth, the words of the comforting words of salvation, okay? Telling you need to repent, come back unto the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Lord and rehearse them, okay? And keep them to the best of your ability. You're not going to be perfect. Believe in Yahweh Shai. See, this is what we're doing right now, but you're not listening. We're piping right now. Okay. Hosea says, well, set a trumpet in your mouth and give warning unto the Israelites. The same thing we're doing right now. But you're not listening. Okay, you're not listening. What is it we lack in this generation? It is a fucked up generation. A senseless, unspiritual generation. But it's fine. Okay. Search for the soul to the soul, search for the sperm to the sperm. Jeremiah 15. All of it's gonna come to pass, and we're gonna see who the fuck has been a joke all this time alone. All you scoffers who busy scoffing on the common boss, we're gonna see in that day, when that day comes, who was wrong and who was right. Okay. And a lot of you are gonna find out, okay, that a lot of you have been led astray. The truth was in front of you, but you made fun of it. You made fun of it, you took it lightly. Okay, you kept on doubting the words of Yahweh Shemashah. Okay, spoken, okay, through men, you kept on doubting. Okay, until it was too late. But there will be nothing but pure regrets. Okay, and your regrets are not going to save you in that day. Okay, your regrets are not going to save you in that day. There's going to be nothing but utter chaos. You're going to be looking for the man who was staying out there in the house in hedges, okay, with their garments, okay, with Bibles in their hands, standing out there on hours, week in and week out. You're going to be looking for them, but you're not going to find the answers. You're going to go to your pastors and you're going to find out they've been fucking telling you lies. They've been preaching to you nothing but what? Prosperity, okay? But there's no peace. Scripture warns you about that. There's no peace. There's no peace for this world. There's nothing. The only thing that's coming for this world is nothing but pure chaos. What? There's nothing but pure chaos that's coming. Let's get it. Exodus 21. Okay. Because this is how things are going right now. Okay. The elite banking families of this world, they're trying to push this cashless system. Okay. To implement the mark of the beast, which is the RFID chip, okay, prophesied in the book of Revelation, chapter 13, known as the mark of the beast, which is the NFC tech, okay, the biochip, okay, the RFID chip, okay, because most people have lost faith in Yahweh Shemashah, they've lost faith in the Lord, okay, because now they're looking for their new master to come and save them, which is Esau Edom. Okay. The scripture says that in the book of Isaiah chapter 31. It says, woe unto them that go to Egypt, okay, for help. Okay, it's gonna be proven that day. You should have never trusted the so-called white men. You should have never trusted the government. Okay, because it's all against the laws of the Bible. Like I read that in 1 John chapter 15, it says, what, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. It's all going to be proven very soon, okay? When they implement this new cashless system, okay? And a lot of you're going to take it, okay? A lot of you are going to take it, right? Because what? Because you've been blinded. You don't know the truth. What? This is Exodus chapter 21, because people, what? They trust in folly. They trust in nonsense. Okay, because when the economy crash, right, they're going to implement, they're going to present to you this RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast. They're going to present to you as a form of solution, and a lot of you are going to go out there flocking. You're going to try to take it, okay, because you're going to be deceived. Okay, this is Exodus chapter 21. heart with some sort of response. And now these are the judgments which thou shalt set before them. It says, if thou by Hebrews 7, 6 says, he shall save thee, and in the seventh he shall, Jesus says, he shall go on free, free for nothing. We don't see this happen. Okay. We don't see this thing happen right now. You born a slave in this society, you're gonna die one. Okay, you're gonna die one. Okay. Anyway, let me go to the point. It says, if he come, Exodus chapter 21, verse 3 says, if he came in by himself, he shall go out by himself. If he were married, then his wife shall go out with him. But if his master had given him a wife, and he shall, and she have borne him sons and daughters, the wife and her children shall be her masters, and he shall go out by himself. Because right now, what's happening right now? The book of Jeremiah says what? It says, Israel bought a home from slave. Why are we spoiled? Okay. That ability as a nation of Israel in the whole, as a whole, we have lost that capability, okay, to supplant. Okay, we have become spiritually dull. Okay, lacking discernment. Okay, not knowing the light, not knowing good for bad, evil from good. Not being able to discern between your right hand and your left hand. Okay, this is the reason why the Lord says, look man, go out there in the houses and hedges and give them warning for me. Okay, put back that skin upon them. Okay, all right, it says Exodus chapter 21, all right, verse 5. It says, and if the servant shall plainly say, I love my master and my wife and my children, and I will not go out free. This is the mentality of a lot of you Israelites. You still love your master, which is Esau, Edom, the so-called white men that we have today, and alongside these different heathens. Okay, you love your masters. That's why you're gonna take that mark of the beast, the RFID chip, because you love your master. You don't love Yahweh Hashem Yahshua, your creator. Okay, even now, when the Lord was here walking 2,000 years ago, what did the wicked scribes and Pharisees say? Let's get it in St. John 19. Okay, this is the problem that we have today. Okay, that's why a lot of you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, Native Americans, you're gonna take that fucking RFID chip, that mark of the beast, and the Lord's gonna fucking kill you for that. Okay, so St. John chapter 19. So St. John chapter 19. So St. John chapter 19, verse 15. Alright, the same thing we see happening today. Okay, they love their master. Even 2,000 years ago, they love their master. Alright, so St. John chapter 19, verse 15. But they cry out, away with him, away with him, crucify him. Peter saith unto them, shall I crucify your king? The chief priest answered, we have no king but Caesar. Because they've forgotten the Abash Masha. Okay, they have a new Caesar right now working on the scene. Esau, Edom. Okay, the same Edomites that were there back then, the Romans, the Edomites. Okay, we still have them today in rulership right now. Okay. And a lot of you Israel, you love your masters. Okay, you love your master. If your master, as your master said, you need not equal rights, yeah, you're done with that. Your master says homosexuality is good, yeah, you're done with that. Okay. Because you love your master, you don't love the Lord. Okay. That's why a lot of you already been conditioned, okay, into taking that mark of the beast. It is not philosophy, it is not Christianity, but it's the RFID chip technology. That is what the mark of the beast is. Okay. Go back to Exodus 20:21. This is the book of Exodus chapter 21, verse 5 says, and if the servant shall plainly say, I love my master and my wife and my children, I will not go out are free. They don't want to be free. St. John chapter 3 says, well, these guys are so fucking wicked, they don't want to come to the light. Okay, because their own deeds were evil, they do not want to come to the light. Just like scripture says in Job 24, says these are they which rebel against the light. Two says they have been rebelling against the light, man. Okay, for generation upon generation. Okay. That's why we still have those who kill the prophet. Okay, Yahweh Shai spoke against them. They said, look, man, oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, thou killest the prophet. Because they love the world, they're so attached, okay, to the customs, okay, of these nations, that they were willing to kill the Lord. Okay. And they handed him down to be crucified by these Roman soldiers, by these Edomites. Okay. Because they loved their master. And the master back then was the Roman Empire, right? Back then, the Caesars. Okay. The same thing we see happening today. Esau, Edom, the Illuminatis, the Rothschild, the Oppenheimers. These are the new masters today. The modern day masters, of which two-thirds of these so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, you love them. And the Most High is going to destroy you for loving your master. Okay? The Most High is going to destroy you for loving your master. I say, because you don't want to go free. Okay, let's get out in Jeremiah. You don't want to go free. It's the book of Jeremiah. So Jeremiah chapter 2 verse 14 says, is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? Why is he spoiled? Because you no longer have your ruling class mentality, okay? Because you got so enslaved for so too long, you no longer know yourself who you are. Even you will tell you, look, man, you're the prince of the power, man. You still under this slave mentality. See, you don't acknowledge who you are, your nationality. You still want to be a goddamn fucking slave. That's what goes, you love your master so much. And the law is going to destroy you. Okay? Two-thirds are going to be cut off and die. There's no other way around it. Okay? Back to Exodus 21. Verse 6 is that, then his master shall bring him unto the judges, and he shall also bring him out to the door, and unto the door post. And his master shall bore his ear through the owl, and he shall serve him forever. The same thing is the modern day master that he's trying to do. Okay, he's trying to insert that mark of the beast on your right hand, okay, or on your forehead. As well, because you're pledging allegiance to the modern day masters of this society, which is Esau, Edom, okay, the elite, our backing families, okay, the Illuminati, the Rothschild, the Oppenheimers, okay, the Rockefellers. These are the new masters that the two-thirds of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans each want to pledge allegiance to. Okay, you don't want to be left to be that free. Okay, you don't want to, you do not want to see yourself being let free, because you love your master. Because you love your master. Let's get Revelation chapter 13. Let's have Revelation chapter 13, verse 16. It says, he causes all folks, small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive the mark of the mark. Revelation chapter 13 verse 16, he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, that no man might buy or sell, save he that have the mark of the beast, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Okay, because it's going to be what? This is going to be a new system that's going to be used in this new upcoming new world order that elites are trying to establish. You're no longer going to be using coins or paper money, okay? That money, okay, is going to be what? It's all going digital, okay? You're not going to find physical money. We already don't have physical money to start off with, okay? There is the very same paper money we have today. It's not even fucking real money anyway. So Esau is starting to do away with all of that, and that money okay, all the digital currency is gonna all be stored on the biochip, okay? So that you could pledge your allegiance unto Esau, and he will gonna know every single thing that you do. Okay, what time do you go to bed? What time do you go to work? Okay, how many jobs do you work? How many people pay you? Okay, how much do you earn? All these things Esau wants to know, all of it. Okay, he's gonna be able to have an eye on you, man. Okay, you're gonna be under surveillance 24/7. Okay, and first of all, you're not even supposed to have any form of mark upon your flesh to begin with. Okay, so you know, automatically you're not supposed even to take that biochip. Okay, even if you're gonna be presented whether you live or whether you die. Okay, and it's gonna come to that point very soon. It's either you're gonna be put to death for taking that mark of the beast. Okay. It's either you're gonna be put to death for not taking the mark of the beast. Okay, the NFC tech, the RFID chip, okay, that biochip, the biotechnology. It's either you take it or you die. Hey, these are the times you're coming into. Okay. You're gonna be tortured, or either you take it. Okay. That's why the Lord says, be thou faithful even unto death. But, and all of it is what it requires faith. Okay, it all requires faith. And you can't make no excuse that you were never warned. Okay, you cannot make that kind of excuse that you were never warned. The warning kept on going for. Okay, the warning kept on going for. Every single corner you call, every single news article you open, everything is all about cashless. If everything is going cashless, you think you're gonna be paying with your smartphone forever? Tap and go? No, man. Okay, you've just been conditioned right now. Okay, the main aim is to have that mark of the beast on your arm. Okay, on your right hand. Whatever you on your left, any part of your body, whatever be on your shoulder. That's the main target, that's the main aim. Okay, by these elites. Okay, that's what they're aiming for. A new cashless, new world order. Okay, and guess what? And a whole mass number of the population. Okay, that's what on the agenda. But guess what? World War III will happen. And guess what? Their plans are going to all be disappointed. Because the Lord does not want to see this happen. Okay, that's not how the scripture has prophesied things to go down. Okay, the new world order will not stand. Okay, because Yahweh Shai is on his way. The Messiah will not allow the new world order to stand. Okay, the Illuminati. Okay, the new world order will not stand. Okay, as is prophesied in the Holy Scriptures, will not stand. Okay, not every single person will receive the mark of the beast. Okay, the mark of the beast, not all the elect of the nation of Yasharada will not take the mark of the beast, which is the RFID chip technology. Okay, that biochip, the elect are not going to take it. Okay, because they're going to know what the mark of the beast is. It's not philosophy. Okay, it's not Christianity. Okay, but it's the biochip technology. That is what the mark of the beast is. Okay, and you're not supposed to take it. Right, and you're not supposed to take it at all. Right, it's Revelation chapter 14, right, verse 9. This is going to be the judgment, those who are going to take the mark of the beast. Okay. Just, and the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark, in his forehead or in his hand, okay, it doesn't matter whether it's going to be your left hand or your right hand. As long as you receive it, you have that fucking thing on your flesh, there's no repenting for you. Okay, your destruction is sealed. Okay, it says Revelation chapter 14 and 9 says, the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive the mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the Most High, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with the fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And that fire is going to be when the intercontinental ballistic missiles hit, okay, the United States of America. Okay, those of you who are going to be there, who are there in Babylon, who are going to be deceived, okay, trusting in Pharaoh. Let's get this in Isaiah 31. Alright, this is the book of Isaiah chapter 31. Because the Lord has warned those who trust in Pharaoh, okay? Those who trust in this modern day society. The Lord has given us a warning against those who trust in Pharaoh. But he said, who's the modern day Pharaoh? The Edomites, Esau, Edom, the so-called white men, as we know, to be linked back in families of them. Okay, it's Isaiah chapter 31. All right, it's Isaiah chapter 31. All right, verse 1 says, Boaz then will go down to Egypt for help and stay on horses and trust in the chariots because they are many, and the horsemen because they are very strong. But they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord. Because like I said in Hebrews 11 chapter, okay, everything that they see, okay, is all projected through the carnal sight. Okay, so that's why they're going to go to Esau, to Pharaoh. The modern day Pharaoh, which is Esau, Edom, they're gonna go to him for help. Okay, in the day of distress and anguish. Okay, when it's gonna be famine, the lack of food and water, all kind of chaos happening, all kind of diseases are breaking loose. In order for you to get that vaccination, it's gonna be part of your job to get cheap. They're gonna go to Esau for help. That's what the Lord says, woe unto you, destruction unto you in that day. When all trials and tribulation, okay, comes in, you're gonna go to Esau. The Lord is saying, woe unto you, destruction unto you. Okay, because you don't have faith in Yahweh. The Lord says, destruction unto you in that day. Right? It says, woe unto them that go down to Egypt for help. And it says, and stay on horses and trust in the chariots because they are many. Okay, and it says in the horsemen because they are very strong, but they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord. The same thing we see happen right now. Okay, they trust in this infrastructure, okay, the global scheme of things about the economy which is set up, of which is fucking big. They don't see this thing is gonna come. The stock market is already dwindling. Okay, it's only about time the economy crashes. Okay, it's only about time that we see a total shutdown of the all global economy. We see the recession happen. 2007, the global collapse. We see that happen. But the third time when it happens, it's going to be forever. Okay, this place will not be rebuilt. It is all going to be destroyed. Okay, and when that happens, all kind of diseases are going to be let loose. Okay, Jesus is going to offer you up a vaccination. Of which is not going to be the fucking vaccination anyway. It's going to be what? It's going to be depopulating you even furthermore. Those of you going to be still alive, if he sees this, he's going to try to say, well, you got this vaccination so you don't get infection. So guess what? What's going to be required of you in order for you to get that vaccination? You're going to have to get yourself chipped. Okay. You're going to have to receive that mark of the beast in order for you to receive that vaccination. Okay. And guess what? Even when you get that vaccination, it's not going to help you. It's even going to kill you, because that's the main diabolical plans that elites have, is to depopulate the society, to depopulate the world. See, the medicine of Esau and the so-called white men is nothing but poison. It is not medicine. These vaccines are the same thing that gets you that make you sick. Okay, these are the disease that you're getting vaccinated against the disease is already in that vaccination. Okay, says Isaiah chapter 31, all right, okay, verse 1 again says, woe unto them that go to Egypt, all right, for help, and stay on horses and trust in chariots because they are many, and it says in the horsemen because they are very strong, but they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord Yahweh Shemasha. Because you trust in the carnal things, not having the understanding that Yahweh Shemasha, look man, what the weapons of Yahweh Shemasha are far more exceedingly greater than the weapons that we see in front of us. Okay, the Most High Yahweh Shemasha, he's undefeated. Okay, he's the man of war, Exodus 15:3. The Lord himself is the man of war. So how can you possibly think you're going to defeat the God of war, Yahweh Shemasha, the God of the Bible? It's impossible. So where's your loyalty supposed to be lying? It's supposed all of your loyalty is supposed to be at the Lord's presence. Okay, not trusting in men, Okay. And that all of it is going to require faith at the end of the day. Because not all men have faith either way. Okay, not all men have that faith. Okay. It says, verse 2, Isaiah 31, verse 2 says, yet he will also, says, yet he also is wise and will bring evil. Just like Esau is able to bring all kind of chaos. Okay, they call it order, says chaos, order out of chaos. The Most High is still able to do all of that, even better. Okay, the kind of strength and power that Esau influence has, it is given from him, from the Heavenly Father. And how much more Yahweh Shemashah is able to do that. Hebrews goes into that, let's get out of Hebrews 10. Let's the book of Hebrews chapter 10. When you're going to be out here fearing Esau, look man, Esau, man, he's just a puppet of Yahweh Shemashah. This is Hebrews chapter 10, verse 11 says, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power. Yahweh Shemashah is a fearful thing. Okay. Okay, it says Isaiah 31 verse 2 says, yet he also is wise and will bring evil. Okay, and it says, and he will not call back his words, but will arise against the house of the evildoers and against the help of them that work iniquity. If you join unto the Esau, though join hand in hand, the wicked shall not at all be left unpunished. That's because you have joined yourself unto Esau and his system. You believe in the Esau system. Hey, guess what? We are in the world anyway. But guess what? We don't have our hearts set upon this place. We don't have our minds set toward this place. Because we know the flesh of this world passes away. Okay, we know that for a fact, that the flesh of this world will pass away. So look, man, we know this for a fact. Okay. This place is going second down the drains. Okay, it's only about a matter of time. But we're here in this world, but we're making use of this world, but not as in abusing the world. Okay, we're making use of it, but we're not abusing this world. Okay? Well, it says Isaiah 31 verse 2 says, but I will arise against the house of the evil doers and against them that help them that work iniquity. Okay, so the Most High, he's the ultimate judge. Okay, he's the ultimate judge. Right? That's why he's the only one who must be feared, and none else. He's the ultimate judge. Okay, he's the one that rules in the kingdom of men. The book of Daniel 4:17. Okay, it is the decree by the watchers to the intent that the living, that they may know that the Most High rules in the kingdom of men. And right now he has set up, the one who set up right now, it is the basis of men who've been set up right now. And who allowed Esau? The Most High, Yahweh Shemashah. Okay. And right now he's about to go into perdition. Okay. His time is up. He has part of a short season. Okay, so why build yourself in a society whereby everything is on a lease right now? Everything is leasing. Okay, leasing onto the fire. Okay, all things are going to be turned upside down. Okay, all things are going to be turned upside down. Because of course Esau is trying to insert an owl. Okay, in wickedness. Okay, Ezekiel 31 is 20. Ezekiel 28. Says that that knowledge is a corrupted thing. Okay. Because he takes the knowledge on the right hand side and he uses it for wickedness. Okay, on the left hand side. Okay. That's why the Yahweh Shemashah is going to destroy the society. Okay. Because the folly that we see happening, and because the wickedness that's happening, and the lies and the different levels of delusions, different levels of illusions that we see happening right now, and people are rejoicing in these different illusions. Okay, then they don't want to come to the light. That's why the Lord is going to destroy this place, because people trust in lies. Okay, they rather hear lies rather than for them to hear truths. Okay, they trust in lies rather wanting to know the truth. That's why the Lord is going to destroy the society, because it is all about what is it is based and founded upon lies. That's why the Lord is going to destroy this place. Okay, the Lord is going to destroy the society, and it's going to be gruesome destruction. Okay, it's going to be a painful death. Right? God. It's a Jeremiah. It's a Jeremiah chapter 26, verse 13 says, "Therefore now amend your ways and your doings, and obey the voice of the Lord Yahweh Shemashah, your power, and the Lord will repent of him the evil that he have pronounced against you." Because the Most High will show mercy. Okay, that's why it says in Romans the 9th chapter, it says he will show mercy on whom he will show mercy. Okay, this is mercy right now, that we're still able to stand here in the house and hedges and call upon the scriptures. It's mercy from Yahweh Shemashah. Okay, it is mercy from Yahweh Shemashah. As we still rehearsing these righteous acts, it's mercy from the Lord. Okay, it is mercy being showed right now. Okay, it says Jeremiah 26 verse 13 says, "Therefore now amend your ways and your doings, and obey the voice of the Lord your power, and the Lord will repent of him the evil that he has pronounced against you. As for me, behold, I am in your hand. Do with me as seemeth good, and meet unto you." Because hey, guess what, man? Just like Jeremiah was facing these fucking false prophets, okay? They wanted to fucking kill him. Okay, guess what? The same thing come in the same lot as the servants of the Lord, man, okay? Whatever happens, happens, man, okay? A servant is no greater than his master, okay? The Lord and Savior, when he was here, he was hated by the world, okay? They eventually got him killed. The same thing's gonna happen. But guess what? There's no fucking death unto the elect of the Lord. Okay, there's only resting. You only rest. Okay, when your spirit leaves the body, it only returns to the Father. Okay, and guess what? Those who were dead in Yahweh Shai, Book of 1 Thessalonians 5, the dead in Yahweh Shai shall arise first. This is the kind of hope and faith that we have in the Lord. The dead in Yahweh Shai shall arise first. So when you die in the truth, it's an automatic crown. Okay, that's an automatic victory over the world. Alright, with that, all praises be unto Yahweh, Bashim, Yahushua, Bashim, Akakadash, double honors unto you, elders, apostles, of great millstone, the elders of down, salutation. So you sincere Akim out there on houses and hedges, preaching the name of Yahweh, Bashim, Yahushua, Bashim, Akakadash, in spirit and truth and sincerity. Alright, Shalom. Death, destruction to displacement, okay? All three is on its way, firming. Okay, don't take the mark of the beast, the RFID chip. Okay, don't bow down to Esau, man, okay? That which thou have already hold firm till Yahweh Shai comes. Alright, Shalom.